80% of Americans don't even know they have a high blood pressure. I mean, forget about 130 or 140. If you can identify that you have a hypertension, I think we can make a big difference.
And that's why there's been a change that means more Americans could now have high blood pressure, and a change that means you're treated earlier.
And News Channel 3's Erica Mokay has the numbers you need to know in this week's Doc Talk.
Broken down into categories, highlighted in bright colors. What's normal and what's not has changed.
For more than a decade, doctors started treating patients for high blood pressure at 140 over 90 millimeters of mercury. But now, that's no longer the case.
According to the American Heart Association and the American College of Cardiology, the new guidelines are designed to help people address the potentially deadly condition much earlier. Take a look right there in gold. It says you should be treated for hypertension when the top number is between 130 and 139, the bottom 80 to 89.
So basically it came down 10 points for the higher number and 10 points for the lower number, that they may live longer, they'll have less complications throughout their life, less kidney problems, less heart disease. So basically we're really improving the quality of life.
The elevated category has also been added. If you're in that range, Dr. Vishal Gupta says you need to be careful.
Hypertension signs could be very subtle. It could be just light fatigue, some shortness of breath on exertion, occasional headaches, but that's something to remember.
Dr. Gupta says you shouldn't be alarmed by these changes, but you should take action. He says ignoring high blood pressure could eventually lead to heart, kidney, and brain problems.
There's a lot of concern, because you know there were a lot of patients who were not hypertensive before and now they're categorized as hypertensive. And there are a lot of patients who thought they had controlled hypertension, now they know that, you know, they're not in that category anymore. Having said that, I think if we look at the long-term outlook, if we start to treat earlier, it's going to be a huge benefit to them.
To get a closer look at that chart, we'll have a link from the American Heart Association with this story on our website, wwmt.com. For Doc Talk, Erica Mokay, News Channel 3.